Color grading is the final step when polishing off your video, but it's tricky. Push one slider too far and your footage can fall apart. In this video, I'll walk you through the basics of color grading in DaVinci Resolve, so you can give your videos that cinematic look. If you're new to DaVinci Resolve, it's important to know that it uses a node-based workflow. This approach is a bit different from what you might be used to in After Effects or Premiere Pro. Nodes in DaVinci Resolve start on the left with your raw footage and flow step by step to the right. You want each node to handle a specific adjustment or effect to keep your changes organized. There are also parallel and mixer nodes, which can handle certain image properties, but for today's video, we'll just focus on serial nodes. In this example, we'll start with a log image, which has a washed out, gray, and desaturated look. This is intentional, as shooting in log provides more flexibility for color correction in post-production. The color page in DaVinci Resolve, with its many panels, parameters, settings, and sliders, can definitely feel overwhelming. However, to master the basics of color grading, you really only need to focus on the primary areas of the interface. On the left, you'll see the timeline viewer, which displays and plays the active clip from your timeline. In the center is the timeline itself, where each video clip is represented by its corresponding clip color from the edit page. If you prefer a cleaner layout, you can hide the timeline by clicking the timeline button at the top of the page. Thumbnails are also already active, so it's easy to switch between clips. If needed, you can also hide thumbnails by clicking the clips button. On the right, you'll find the node graph, where you can create and manage the node structure of your grades. Unlike the edit page, where the effects panel is located on the left, the color page places it on the right. Additionally, in the color page, effects are applied by dragging them onto a node, whereas in the edit page, they're applied directly onto a video clip. Below the node graph are the primary color wheels, which are used to adjust color, exposure, and other basic settings. This section also lets you switch to color bars or log wheels, but for now, we'll stick to the essentials. This panel also houses additional tools, such as HDR controls and color matching options. Again, these are advanced features that we'll cover in a different tutorial. The curves panel is where you can work with custom curves and adjust key attributes like hue, saturation, and luminance. To the right, you'll find tools like the color slice and color warper. These are advanced tools, so again, they're not essential at this stage. What may be more important to focus on are the qualifier and power window. These are two key tools for color grading. The qualifier isolates specific parts of an image for adjustments, while the power window lets you mask and control certain areas. Next to the power window is the tracker and stabilizer tool, which stabilizes shaky shots and ensures effects are accurately tracked within your footage. Finally, we have the most important area, the scope section. Scopes are like audio level meters, but for visuals, guiding you in exposure and color balancing. You can customize the scope type to your needs, switching between RGB parade, waveform, and vector scope. In this tutorial, we'll use the RGB parade. This scope shows waveforms for the red, green, and blue color channels. The height of each waveform indicates brightness, with the bottom representing shadows. To add sufficient contrast to a standard corrected image, you'll want these waveforms to extend across the entire graph and for each peak to be equal. Before we continue, it's important to note that color correction and color grading are unique to each clip, as factors like color space, lighting, temperature, and contrast vary. The first step in the color grading process is applying a technical LUT or lookup table. A LUT converts your footage to a standard color space. To add a LUT in DaVinci Resolve, start by selecting the first node. Right-click and navigate to LUT in the menu. Then choose the color space that matches your camera's footage. For this video, shot with the Sony FX6 in S-Log3, we'll select LUT, Sony, S-Log3 to Rec 709. DaVinci Resolve offers a variety of built-in LUTs, and you can preview them in the menu on the right-hand side to see how they'll look applied to your image. If you don't find the LUT you need, your camera manufacturer likely provides downloadable options online. Once applied, the LUT will improve contrast and saturation, making the image more accurate to how it looked on your production. However, this is just a starting point, as brightness, saturation, and color may still need adjustments. The next step is to create a serial node by pressing Alt plus S, or Option plus S on Mac. This node will be used to start correcting the image. Depending on the base image and the LUT, the contrast might be too high, causing underexposure or overexposure. In the clip we're working on, the highlights aren't quite as extreme. So to correct the exposure, we can just use the primary color wheels. In the primary color wheels, you'll see four controls: lift, gamma, gain, and offset. Lift adjusts the shadows or darker areas. Gamma controls the midtones. Gain affects the highlights or brighter areas, and offset impacts the entire image. If you increase the gain slider, the highlights in the image will get brighter, which you'll also see reflected in the top part of the scopes. If you then move the central control dot towards blue, you'll add blue into the highlights. The goal is to achieve a nice contrast spread in the scopes. This usually involves adjusting the lift to keep shadows from dipping too low, tweaking the gamma, and slightly raising the gain. By the end, you'll have a more balanced image with good dynamic range. Toggle the nodes on and off to see the difference visually and in the contrast levels on the scopes. Next, we can enhance the colors by adding a bit of saturation, increasing it from 50 to 55 for a better looking image. However, the scopes reveal an issue. The red, green, and blue peaks aren't balanced, with the blue channel standing out. This gives the image a cold tone, especially in the sky. Before moving on to grading, we need to correct this color imbalance. The easiest way is with the temperature dial. While you can do this on the primary correction node, let's add a new node to stay organized. As you adjust, watch the scopes. You'll see the blue peak drop and the red peak rise. The goal is to balance these peaks as evenly as possible. Once the temperature is balanced, we can fine-tune the highlights using the gain color wheel to neutralize any remaining color casts. Color correction is all about making small adjustments and going back and forth to find the right balance. It's rarely a linear process, so even minor tweaks can have a really big impact. For more significant color shifts, you would want to use the primary color wheels on a node added after the transform LUT. Now that you've completed the color corrections, you can move on to grading the image. Color grading is about applying a specific look and creating a tone that matches the emotion or theme of the sequence. For example, this shot takes place in a moody environment, so our grading will enhance the mood to reflect the scene's atmosphere. This scene was shot on an overcast day, providing naturally soft lighting, which is ideal for filming. However, we'll want to make the focus more intentional. To achieve this, you can apply a power window and create a subtle vignette. First, add a new node and then open the power window tool, which is located as a circular icon in the central tools area. Select a circular window and place it in the center of the composition. With the power windows tool selected again, be sure to adjust the softness so the edges blend seamlessly. Next, lower the offset slightly to reduce the exposure. If this darkens the center, which wasn't your desired effect, click the invert mask button. This adjustment will darken the edges of the frame, creating a vignette effect that draws the viewer's attention towards the center and highlights the talent. While the image is now technically correct in terms of color, narrative filmmaking is about invoking emotion, not just technical perfection. Start by adding a new node and using the offset wheel to shift the colors towards green and blue, giving the image the murkier and moodier feel. To keep the shadows balanced and prevent them from becoming too blue, use the lift wheel and move the center dot slightly towards red to warm them up. Small adjustments are usually enough to create a noticeable hue shift here. In the same node, use the gain wheel to add a subtle touch of green or yellow, which will enhance the atmosphere in the sky. Finally, lower the temperature to give the scene a colder, more intense look. At this point, the image's tone might seem similar to where it started, but the process here is crucial. If you toggle off the color correction node, specifically the color balance node, you'll notice the talent's skin tones appear too blue and unnatural. Preserving realistic skin tones is critical in color grading, which is why starting with proper corrections ensures this balance is maintained later. Skipping straight to grading can make issues like this much harder to fix. From here, add a new node to decrease the tint, introducing a green shift to the image. Then, lower the saturation to 35 and increase the contrast. This mix of higher contrast and lower saturation creates a subtle bleach bypass look, with the green tint enhancing the overall mood. Create another node and apply film grain using the 35mm 200T preset, and increase the opacity to 0.6. The result is a stylistic, moody shot ideal for a serious drama. Following the correct process is essential for maintaining color harmony throughout the image in order to achieve your final result. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Then head over to storyblocks.com for unlimited downloads of royalty-free 4K footage, templates for DaVinci Resolve, music, and more.